What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo, and today is all about deploying Windows 11 23H2 with SCCM using the task sequence. So let's get right into it. All right, so the first thing that we need to do is launch our configuration manager. Now, before we do anything and get into the task sequence, we got to make sure that we are pulling down Windows 11 feature updates. So to do that, we're going to go into administration. We're going to go into site configuration, click on sites and select your site, right click on it, and we are going to go into configure site components and we are going to pick software update point. From here, we're going to click on the products tab and then we're going to scroll down all the way down until we see Windows 11. Just make sure you have that enabled. I'm guessing that a lot of us already pulling down Windows 11 feature updates down to your SCCM server. So we are going to close this up. From here, we are going to get into software. Within software, we are going to go into Windows servicing and select all Windows feature updates. You should see a crap load of Windows feature updates. Now, on the last video, we actually downloaded Windows 11 23H2 and packaged that. So that's what I'm going to use for this video. Now, let's get into the operating systems folder. Within here, let's select task sequences. Let's right click on the task sequence node and let's click on create a task sequence. We're going to get the task sequence wizard. So we are going to select upgrade an operating system from an upgrade package. We're going to click next here. You're going to provide a task sequence name. This is what I provided. We're going to click next. Now for the upgrade package, it does not matter what you select. It has that option, install the following feature update. So I could have just selected that. So I just noticed something during the recording and it didn't cross my mind because at this point I did not see install the following feature update, right? So I'm going to show you guys what I did to accomplish everything. But in reality, you don't really need to do this part right here. You could just select install the following feature update and then just select the feature update that you already downloaded, right? I didn't catch that. So what I did was I actually clicked on browse and I just selected any upgrade package. Did not matter what I picked, but I picked the Windows 11 one and I clicked OK. I click next here. I left everything as the default, click next. For the app section, I left everything as the default. I click next, a nice little summary, click next, and it completed and I closed it. I wasn't paying attention. I was just basically doing it my own ways, but already inside the task sequence, you could actually pick the feature upgrade. I didn't know that. This is how I got around it because I didn't catch it. I selected my task sequence, the new one that I just created. I right clicked on it and I clicked on edit and I went inside the upgrade operating system section. And what I did was I selected install the following feature update, which I could have done that during the creation of the task sequence. And I just didn't catch that until now. Oh my God, that's crazy. I clicked on that, I think an orange star. And I went inside classifications, I went inside upgrades, I went inside Microsoft, and I went inside Windows 11. And you should see basically everything that you already pre-downloaded. I think one of them is not downloaded, but it's still there, which is okay. I'm going to select the one that I want, which would be the third one. I gave it a nice little check mark. I clicked OK here. I applied it. I clicked OK. I basically right-clicked on the task sequence that I just made the modifications on, and I clicked on deploy, and I clicked on browse, and I got this nice little warning. I clicked OK, and I selected my collection that I want to distribute and advertise this task sequence into. So it would be my Windows 11 collection. I clicked OK here. I clicked next here. For purpose, it's up to you. You are able to do available or required. For my environment, I actually made it available. I click next here. Now for scheduling, I left it as the default. So I clicked on next. For user experience, I left everything as the default, but I do recommend checking off system restart if required to complete the installation, restart the machine. Once you make your modifications here, click next. For alerting, I left it as the default. I click next. For the distribution point, I left everything as the default. Click next again. For the deployment package, like I said before, I already did a video with this Windows 11 23H2 package. So I already did everything. If you don't have the deployment package, you could create a new one, but I already have one. So I'm going to click browse here. I'm going to select my package. I'm going to click OK. I'm going to click next here. I left everything as the default for the download location. Click next. Language, default. Click next here. A nice little summary. Click next and complete it. Green check mark is always a good thing within the SCCM world. Click close and then you should be good. Now, within that Windows 11 collection, I actually have one Windows 11 machine. So I basically went over there. I launched my software center. Within the operating system section, you're going to see your new task sequence. If you select it, you click install. It would take some time. It's going to reboot a couple of times, and then you're up and running with the latest build. That's it. Hopefully you guys enjoy this video, and I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.